Hello everyone, you're watching Saheb Academy. If you like our videos, then please subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon, and also follow us on Instagram, Saheb Academy. Now let's go to the video. Hi everyone, this is the third video of branch accounts chapter, and in this video we are going to see what is meant by invoice price and the accounting treatment that is required when the branch account problem is based on invoice price. Alright, so let's understand what is invoice price. See, when the goods are being sent from head office to branch at a price higher than cost price, then it is known as goods sent at an invoice price. Why is it higher than cost price? That is because, see, for that you have to understand the mathematical formula of invoice price. See, invoice price is equal to cost plus profit. So to arrive at invoice price, the cost is added with a percentage of profit. Okay, so invoice price is equal to cost plus profit, and this profit is also known as, in technical terms, is also known as loading. Okay, in most of our books it is mentioned as loading, so we will use that word from now onwards. All right, see, invoice price is equal to cost plus profit. Let's say a company incurred cost of 1,000 rupees to produce a product. Okay, now it is sending that good to its branch, but it is not sending it at cost, it is sending it at invoice price by adding a margin of profit, that is 200, right? That is 20% of 1,000. So 200 is added with 1,000 to arrive at invoice price 1,200. So this 1,200 is the invoice price, so then 1,000 is cost, and this 200 is loading, and the percentage of loading is 20%. All right, you got the idea? Okay, now let's see the calculation required to calculate the invoice price from questions. Now let's see this example. Goods costing 2 lakh are sent to branch at cost plus 20%. So here they have said goods costing 2 lakh. Okay, goods costing 2 lakh are sent to branch. Alright, this is always given in the question. In the main content of the problem, it is always given in the question. Goods, this much cost of goods are being sent to branch. So it is given here 2 lakh. So that becomes our cost. We know that invoice price is equal to cost plus profit, right? So to find invoice price, first we'll take that cost, 2 lakh, alright? And then we need profit, right? We need profit, the loading. So at cost plus 20%. So they have said cost plus 20%. So cost plus 20% means this percentage is based on cost price, okay? 20% on cost. So we'll take 20% on cost. So cost is given here, right? 2 lakh. So we will take 20% of 2 lakh. See, 2 lakh into 20%. That is equal to 40,000. All right. So 40,000 would be the loading or the profit. And the invoice price would be 2,40,000. See, this is how you find the invoice price. All right. Easy, right? Now let's see another problem. See, goods costing 150,000 are sent to branch at 30% above cost. Now here also they have said goods costing 1,50,000. So we got the cost, that is 1,50,000, right? 150,000 plus now profit or loading. Here they have said at 30% above cost. Above cost means 30% of cost, okay? In simple terms, it means 30% of cost. So don't get confused, alright? They just twist the words. So at 30% above cost. Now 30% above cost means 1,50,000 into 30%. That is equal to 45,000. Alright? 45,000. So we get 195,000. Easy, right? This is how you find the invoice price. We have the formula, right? Invoice price. Invoice price is equal to cost plus profit. Okay. All right. Now let's see another example. Now here's the third example. Goods costing 4,20,000 are sent to branch. So they have given us goods sent to branch at the cost price 4,20,000, as usual, same as last two examples. Okay. At 20% on invoice price. Here they have said 20% on invoice price. Okay, let's see. So how are we going to find the invoice price? Same formula, invoice price is equal to cost plus profit, right? Cost plus profit. Now we have got the cost here, 420,000, isn't it? So we write that 420,000. Then profit, we need profit. Now we can't calculate 20% on 420,000. Why? That's because this is 20% not on cost, it is on invoice price. See, in the previous examples, it was cost plus 20%, so it was 20% on cost. But in the third example, it is based on invoice price. The loading percentage or the profit percentage is based on invoice price. We don't have invoice price, we have only cost price. So we can't calculate 20% on 420,000. We can't do that. So what we can do is we can convert this percentage. Yeah, we can convert this percentage from invoice price to cost price. Okay, so how are we going to do that? See, I will show you. Before conversion, I will tell you two important things. Okay, see, the cost is right. The cost will be always will be always less than the invoice price. Always remember that, because cost is cost, but the invoice price is including cost and profit. Invoice price means cost plus profit. So invoice price will always be higher than cost price. Okay, tip number two, the cost, I take it like cost is minus and invoice price here as plus. Why? Because to arrive at invoice price, we add profit. To arrive at cost price, we deduct the profit. Okay, now let's see the conversion. I will show you what I mean by this. All right, see, now we have here 20% on invoice price, right? So we have 20%, we have 20% on invoice price, and we need to convert this into cost. How are we going to do that? See, what I told you, to arrive at cost, we need to deduct the profit. So what are we going to do is 20 divided by, it is supposed to come 100, right? 20% means 20 by 100, but we are going to take 20 by 80. We are going to deduct that 20%. All right, 20 by 80 and percentage, that is 100. So let's calculate that. 20 divided by 80 into 100, that is 25%. See, so now we got the percentage in cost, 25%. Okay, simple, right? How we did the conversion? Invoice price, 20% they gave us, right? So what we did, we took 20 divided by 80. Why 80? We deducted the profit percentage into 100. If it was 30 over here, then you would have taken 70. All right, so 20 by 80 into 100, then we got 25%. All right, then we are going to easily calculate. There's no problem here, right? Then 420,000 into 25%. That percent we just found out, right? 25% on cost, because we have to match the loading percentage and the amount percentage amount. Okay, if here it is cost, here also it has to be cost, otherwise we have to do the conversion. Okay, so we got, how much we got? 1,05,000, right? 1,05,000. 1,05,000 would be the loading, all right, the profit. So we will add that. How much? It is 5,25,000, right? 4 plus 1, 5, 20 plus 5, 25, 5,25,000. Easy, right? You got, right? See, here it was given at cost price. The goods costing 4,20,000. So this was cost, but here it was, the profit percentage was on invoice price. The loading percentage was on invoice price. So we had to convert this percentage to match up with the goods sent to branch so that we can easily calculate the invoice price. All right, easy, right? Okay, now the thing is, when you see the branch problem in your examination paper, first you need to look for two things. First, the loading, and the second thing is goods sent to branch. This will be either in the top of the question or at the bottom of the question. And goods sent to branch will be mainly in the content of the problem, okay? So you need to see whether the loading percentage is on cost or on invoice price, okay? How to identify that? See, here in our first example, we saw cost plus 20%. This is the loading percentage, yeah? So the loading percentage here, it is based on cost, because it is said cost plus 20%. yeah, common sense. And then here, percentage on invoice price. Now, how we are going to know it is based on invoice price? See, 20% on invoice price. It will be clearly given to you. If it is given 20% on sales price, that means it is on invoice price. So you have to see whether the loading is given on cost or on invoice price, the percentage, all right? Next, you have to see goods sent to branch. So you have to see goods sent to branch, whether it is given in cost or at invoice price, okay? See, in all these three examples, it was on cost. Costing 4,20,000, costing 2 lakh, then here it was costing 1,50,000, you see, all cost. So the thing is, you have to see whether they match the percentage on cost and the amount in cost. If both are on cost, then it is no problem. You can easily calculate the invoice price, as we did in the example 2 and the example 1. Both were on cost, so we directly calculated 30% on the goods sent to branch, and we got the profit, the loading, and we found the invoice price, same as we did in the first example. See, costing, cost plus 20%, both on cost, so no need of conversion. Directly we took 20% on 20% of 2 lakh, and we found 2,40,000. We added and we found the invoice price, right? So the conversion arises only when there is a difference between the loading percentage and the goods sent to branch amount. All right, you got that right? And I told you how to convert. That was here. C is always less than IP, the first tip. All right, and the second tip is C is minus and IP is plus, because IP, to arrive at IP, we add the profit, and to arrive at cost, we deduct the profit. So to convert, what we did, 25% on cost. If it is 25% on cost, then we will add the profit. All right, 25 divided by 100, right? But we will take 125, because we will add the profit percentage. Okay, so 25 divided by 125 into 100. 100 means the percentage. So 25 divided by 125 into 100. See, here's the calculator. 25 divided by 125 into 100. It is equal to 20. See, we got 20%, right? We got 20%. So 20% on invoice price. This is how we convert the percentages of loading. All right. And this arises only when the percentage and the amount doesn't match up. All right. If it matches, then no problem. Okay, you got the idea, right? Now let's see the accounting treatment required when the problem is based on invoice price. Okay, now let's see the accounting treatment that is required when goods are sent at an invoice price. See, when the goods are sent at an invoice price, the main focus will be on these four items: the opening stock, closing stock, goods sent to branch, goods returned by branch. All right, and these four items will always appear at invoice price. When the problem is based on invoice price, all these four items will be valued at invoice price and given in the invoice price in the question. Okay, so opening stock is always debited, right? Normally it is always, usually it is always debited. Stock is always debited, the opening stock I mean, and the closing stock is always credited. Okay, that's clear. So what happens is, when they appear at invoice price, they get inflated. All right, they get inflated. They have an element of profit in them, so we have to remove that element of profit. Otherwise, if we don't remove that profit, what happens is the debit side get inflated. So if the debit side increases in the branch account, then we will arrive at wrong profit. Okay, our expenditure increases, right? This is nominal account. If the expenditure increases, our profit decreases, and the profit will not be true profit. All right, so we have to remove that profit. So how are we going to do that? We do that by making an equal credit as buy stock reserve. Suppose here there is 1,000. Let's take an example. Here there is 1,000, okay? And in that 1,000, there is 100 profit, 100 margin of profit is there in that 1,000. So what are we going to do? Stock 1,000, as given in the question, we will take 1,000. And on the credit side, we will take buy stock reserve 100, because we need to remove that debit. So to remove that debit of 100, from that 1,000, we have to make an equal credit of 100. All right, you got that right? Okay, next, let's move on. See, next is closing stock. Closing stock also same thing. All right, closing stock is always credited here. So let's say here 2,000 is the closing stock given in the question. You took the stock here 2,000, and let's say 200 in that 2,000 is profit. Okay, invoice price, it is valued at invoice price, right? Let's say there is 200 profit. So that 200 you have to you have to remove it. How are you going to remove that? To remove that, you have to make an equal debit to stock reserve. You will take here 200, okay? To remove that credit. To remove that credit, you have to make an equal debit. All right, that's clear. Closing stock and opening stock, how you will remove the loading. Okay, then let's move on. See, now here, goods sent to branch is there. Goods sent to branch is always debited because it is an expense for the head office to send the goods to the branch, right? So it is always debited. Now it will come over here to GSTB, right? Let's say he sent 2 lakh worth of goods, okay? 2 lakh worth of goods. So 2 lakh will come over here, okay? It is the invoice price, okay? 2 lakh is invoice price. And in that invoice price, let's say 20,000 is profit. So what are we going to do is, we will take as usual 2 GSTB to goods sent to branch 2 lakh, and on the credit side we have to remove that loading. On the credit side we will make same entry by GSTB, okay, by GSTB, by goods sent to branch, to remove the loading. And we will take here only profit, not the whole amount, only profit as we did in the stocks. So we will take 20,000. All right, so this is over. You understood, right? To remove the loading we have to make an equal debit or credit as it is. All right, then here by GSTB. See, next is goods returned by branch. Goods returned by branch, whenever the branch cannot sell the goods in the market, all right, what it does is it sends those goods back to the head office. So whenever those goods are being sent back to the head office, what happens is they include invoice price. All right, so because they were sent at an invoice price, so they are coming back also at an invoice price. It's obvious, right? So let's say 1,000 worth of goods are coming back at an invoice price, and in that 1,100 is profit. So same you have to do. You have to do, make an additional entry over here to GSTB to remove that loading, 100. All right, here there will be 1,000 as given in the question. This will be given in the question to by GSTB. Sorry, the returns will be given in the question. They will say return by branch. So you have to credit that as by GSTB, as we did in the last problem of the branch. So you have to credit it. And then you have to take make a debit entry on the debit side. All right, easy, right? So this is how you remove the loading, and this is the accounting treatment that is required when the problem is based on invoice price. All right, and the same concept applies in consignment accounting. Okay, if the consignment accounting is in your syllabus, then the same concept applies in the consignment. Okay, and in consignment only the name changes. Here it is branch, there is it is consignment. All right, so if it is in your syllabus, please concentrate on this video. All right, okay.